السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. راح نبدي إن شاء الله نكمل اللي يعني توقفنا عنده. لأن مثل ما فهمتكم الموضوع هو أنه أنت بإمكانك تكمل في أي وقت يعجبك، وين ما توقف هو يكمل عندك، يعني يحفظ لك المكان اللي وصلت له. بس أهم شيء تتخطى، يعني حاول قدر الإمكان تتخطى الشابتر بكامله، حتى من ترجع مو ترجع لنفس الشابتر، هو هذا الهدف يعني. فننطيه continue. overview. وين وصلنا؟ الشابتر 6. زين.
chapter 6 exploration for hydrocarbons.
يعني شنو؟ استكشاف الهيدروكربون.
We need to find a structural trap. There are a number of ways that we can map the subsurface structure of the Earth. The most important is the seismic survey.
يعني راح يحكي هو هسه حاليا على السايزميك داتا. فخلينا ندخل بالموضوع.
In the early days, when oil could be found near or sometimes even above the surface, it was quite simple to drill a shallow well which would pierce the reservoir and allow the hydrocarbons to flow to the surface. Nowadays, we need to look deeper for hydrocarbon accumulations, and in order to save time and money on endless exploratory drilling, we use scientific methods and techniques to look deep into the Earth's layers of rock. Looking at the surface of the Earth, geologists can tell quite a lot about the rocks that lie beneath. Using aerial photographs and satellite images, even more information can be gathered. But the most accurate and detailed geological survey which can lead to the extraction of oil is a seismic survey. Seismic surveys are used to map the underground structure of rock formations. Geologists interpret the seismic data in order to locate structural traps that could potentially contain hydrocarbons. So, how does it work? The general principle is to send sound waves into the earth. As the sound waves reach each type of rock formation, the flow of the wave is impeded. The wave literally bounces off the rock. The reflected wave is then recorded using ultra-sensitive devices called geophones and hydrophones. The recorded waves are then converted into electrical impulses, which are then used to build up an image of the underground rock formations. Petroleum geologists then interpret this data to determine rock structures and ultimately to locate oil and gas reservoirs.
هذه عبارة عن معدات تستخدم المن لاستكشاف نوعية الصخور. هذه الصخور اللي موجودة هي كلها من خلال هذه خلينا نقول عليها الموجات الصوتية. هاي الموجات الصوتية لها ترددات، اللي راجع من عندها ويطلق منها موجات صوتية، اللي راجع من عندها ايش راح يكون؟ راح يكون هو يمثل نوع الصخرة وشنو موجود بداخلها، فيحدد من خلالها المكامن النفطية.
As computers have developed over the years, the ability to interpret seismic data has increased. The complexity of the seismic tools have also increased, allowing us to send more complex patterns into the rocks and collect more and better data. The overall result is that the images we are able to create from the data are getting better and more accurate.
العلم هو هذا آخر chapter راح يصير عندنا، وراح يكون عنده يعني راح يكون عندك هذا الفصل، وبعدها اختبار للchapter 6، وبعدين module conclusion، وبعدها final exam. يعني نخلص المودول 1.
Once the development company has the results from the seismic survey detailing the structure beneath the surface, the only way we can absolutely prove the presence of hydrocarbons is to drill.
شوف يعني the only way we can absolutely prove the presence of a hydrocarbon is to drill. يعني من خلال الحفر هو يعني الوحيد اللي انت من خلاله تحدد انه النفط ووجوده بداخل هذا المكان. هسه هنا النولج تشيك. زين وين لوكينج؟ هنا يسألني يقول إنه when looking for detailed geological information, seismic survey is more than accurate than using aerial or satellite image. نمطي صح زين. In order زين. هذا السؤال هنا من اللي يحدد لنا المكامن النفطية أو المصائد النفطية؟ seismic correct
زين. Well done, you've reached the end of this module. You should now be able to recall some of the early uses of crude oil, outline the origins and growth of the oil industry, recognize significant well control events and technological developments, describe why geology is important to the petroleum industry, explain how hydrocarbons are formed, describe where hydrocarbons are found, and identify different methods for finding oil and gas.